Not only can you upgrade the eMMC, but remember what I said? The SoC is the same as the ROG Pro 64. Well, really, the computer is the same as the ROG Pro 64 in a lot of ways, including PCI Express.
Really?
What?
You've
got PCI Express inside that little tiny thin notebook? And because of that, we can actually buy a $7 adapter that will allow us to install an M.2.
Wow.
So I can install an NVMe M.2 storage drive. So that means I could put up to 2 terabytes of storage that has no moving parts, generates very little heat, and is able to give me 2 terabytes of storage in my Pinebook Pro.
That's amazing.
Should we get should we open this thing up and get a look? So on the underside, you see 10 screws. Seems onerous. You know, you've got to open it up with 10 screws, but we can speed that up for the sake of TV and get into this thing a little bit quicker. But understand, that's going to give us access to the internal components. This is a hackable laptop. It is built to be something that we can modify ourselves. That's the key thing with the Pinebook Pro. But remember, it's only $200 US to buy this. It's available from Pine64, and they make this specifically to be a hackable Linux laptop. First time into it, let's get in there. Just want to be careful that I don't break anything, but there we go. Be mindful that the speakers are attached to the bottom panel. There are stereo speakers, so be careful as you're pulling this up. You don't want to pull on that wire, see that? So just kind of safely and carefully peel that back. And there you see the SoC. So that is the plastic component of the chassis. You can see how there is some plastic there. I'm going to put these speakers back before I get too far ahead, because I don't want to accidentally put them in the wrong spot. But let's get a quick close-up of that that SoC, the main board, we'll call it, of the Pinebook Pro. This, again, is the ANSI edition.
Yep.
And under this little flap of tape, we have, this is what I was telling you about, Jeff. This is PCI Express X4. But it looks a little bit different,
yeah,
right?
Okay.
So that's why you need that adapter. My storage, my hard drive, is the 64 gig eMMC. Now, ouch, be careful. I just cut myself. There are some sharp points within the case, so just be careful of that. Sorry about that, folks. But see that eMMC? It just goes right on there. You can upgrade that. It's just a standard eMMC. There's no proprietary part here. You can just buy a 128 gig if you want to upgrade that. And because it's an eMMC, you can pull that out and you can flash any distro onto that card and be able to boot up your Pinebook Pro. But I want to tell you something else. Remember how I showed you that there is a micro SD port on the side?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great, because you can import photos from your camera. Sure.
Okay.
Yeah. However, it's also bootable.
Really?
Yes. Oh. Think about that for a second. So the boot order is micro SD and then eMMC. So even with that eMMC card in there, you can flash any distro for the Pinebook Pro to your micro SD card and boot it up. You can try it out, find out how you like it. You can set it up the way you like it, and then you can wipe it and reflash and install a different distro and then boot it up from a micro SD card, and you never have to open up the chassis. Once you've decided the one that you really love, and there are a growing number of distros available for the Pinebook Pro, once you find the one that you love, you can flash that eMMC card, and that's the one that you're booting from when there's no micro SD in the slot.
Like it.
But a bootable micro SD. Huh. You have 5 micro SDs. You can just put, like, you can put Debian on one. It comes with Debian pre-installed on that that eMMC that I showed you.
Yep.
So that has Debian Stretch installed on it, ready to go. You can boot it up and start working. But you can put Manjaro on there. You can put Ubuntu on another one, and you can boot from them and try them out and give it a try without any risk to the actual built-in eMMC.
Very cool.
How do you like that? So if you intend to do that, if you want to flash your eMMC, make sure when you order your Pinebook Pro from pine64.org that you also buy an eMMC to USB adapter.
Right.
Okay, that's important. So just keep that in mind. What else might you want to add to your cart? I would say probably that M.2 adapter for the PCI Express 4.
Yep.
I'd say that would be a good purchase. throw that on there if you think that you're going to be doing that. I think I'm definitely going to pick up one of those
sure.
so that I can throw a 1 terabyte or 2 terabyte eMMC, or I keep saying that, M.2 into the Pinebook Pro. That's mm-hmm. going to give me storage. So that's not bootable, but that is a storage hard drive.
Right.
So I can mount my home folder, for example, to that M.2 and save all, like have a terabyte worth of home folder storage.
That's awesome.
How do you like that, right?
That is so awesome.